all things of value come with a cost. And this cost, it's essential because without it, there's no triumph. There's no victory. It's what separates out those who really want something, the determined. Why do triathletes compete? Why do rowers row, runners run? At a competitive level, it certainly isn't because it feels good physically. You know, it's quite the opposite. They endure a lot of rough situations, a lot of painful training, because of a tiny light at the end of the tunnel. And that light is how you build upon your self-worth. It's how you define what you're capable of. And success cannot come to be without adversity. How you handle yourself in those adverse situations, that is what defines a person. That is how you build your legacy. There will come a time when it hurts, when you have to ask yourself if it's worth it, and consciously avoid quitting and turning to an easier approach. Remember, anyone can run downhill, not many people can run up. And the interesting thing is that that trophy is usually at the top. Be careful how you conceptualize the word hell, because hell implies that the suffering will never end, that it's the ultimate pain. Three things. One, you can always be worse off than you are. Two, suffering is temporary. And three, when you wake up tomorrow, having given up will be far more painful than anything else you could have done. Everything in life is temporary. There's a quote that's got me through many tough times in my life. And it's that pain is temporary, but quitting is forever. Oh, and how true that is. I can still remember the times in my life where I know I had more to give. That stays with you. But how bad your 2K test hurt, how bad you wanted to sleep before a final exam, the pain in your body during the final stretch of a race, that all dissipates. That becomes pretty meaningless looking back. It's the results that matter. It's the results you remember. Because when the hurt is over, right, the struggle's gone, you either did something great or you didn't. That's when things fall into place. The hell you experienced was simply a vehicle taking you to your destination. So being that you only live once, that you're fortunate enough to have an opportunity to do something significant, why not make it hurt? Rise above what's uncomfortable and see the big picture. Ride it out. Because when all is said and done, the guy who gives more when it hurts gets more when it's over. The ascent. Looking up at the mountain as you make your way from the bottom, when everything, including gravity, is falling on top of you, pushing you down. You know it would be easier to head back down, change course. You know you could stop. But there's something better at the top of the mountain, and it's worth the fight. Not all days are going to feel good, but you know that. Every action will not prove beneficial. You've lived it. That light at the end of the tunnel, it can look awfully small, but with each step, you're making a conscious decision to leave yesterday behind, to seek something better. You know why you're here, why you've been getting up at 5 a.m., the sacrifices you've made. It's because you wanted more. You expect it out of yourself. Simply getting by isn't for you. It's for someone else. Yeah, you feel tired, but it means nothing. Because at the end of the day, you'll either succeed or you won't. And it won't matter how tired you were. Words like if, maybe, they're insignificant. They're for the weak. If you want something, you'll get it or you'll die trying. The failures along the way, they've made you stronger. The wrong turns, they've made you wiser. Nothing is falling into your hands. You've taken the world by storm. Yeah, people are going to say that you can't, that you won't, but they're not you. They don't know what you're capable of. They will. Discomfort, pain, you move through it, step by step. All you can think about now is being on top of that mountain. It's become an obsession. You waste no time feeling sorry for yourself. That simply distracts from your goal. When it hurts the most, you press the hardest. Your body does not control your mind. Your mind controls your body. The higher you ascend, the more momentum you build. Every step builds off the one before it. Every breath brings you closer to the summit. You can feel it now. You've given everything for this, leaning on nothing but the faith you have in yourself. The blood, the sweat, the tears, they've allowed you to create your foundation. Now it's time to build an empire. The thing about time is that it comes and goes. Tomorrow will make today a distant memory, and as quick as you were here, you'll be gone. What's in front of you is an opportunity to make right now something you'll never forget. You have the ability to write history, to create a story that will live with you forever. Think back to all the days leading up to today, all the training, the hours of preparation, the pain you felt. They have brought you to this moment. They are the armor that you wear. Right now is about execution. It's about taking all those hours and turning them into the best version of yourself. Today is about being better than you ever dreamed you could be. These are the moments you live for. Gone are the insecurities, the doubt, the disbelief. This day is yours. Look your opponents in the eye. They cannot give what you can. You have built this opportunity piece by piece. You have created an unstoppable force, and it's finally time to reveal that to the world. Let people doubt you. They'll see with time. Let the obstacles stand. You will run right through them. Let everything in this universe tell you no. You have already told yourself yes. The hardest thing in this world to stop is someone who knows they've won before the game has started. This is your everything. Embrace it. Make it so that you never forget today. You are the god of your world, and in your world, you write the script. There is no tired. You left that in the weight room years ago. There is no one sure. Pushing yourself to exhaustion every day took care of that. There is only when. When do you rise up? There comes a point when you've just given too much. Your sacrifice is too great to accept anything but the very best. Everything else is noise. This is your day. It will not disappear with time. It will live on. You have earned today. Go make sure the world knows. You can search the world, you can look until the end of time, but you'll see that nothing worth doing comes free of charge. There's so much stuff out there, 6-minute abs, all these get-rich-quick schemes. These things that supposedly eliminate the struggle that comes with success. They just magically give you what you want. Let me tell you something. You can never remove the hustle, the failures, the dedication. They are success. They are what success is made from. To hope for some amazing result without the grinding, the lessons learned. It's like never ever watering a seed and expecting it to produce this fruit tomorrow. It just doesn't happen. Doesn't make sense. It's removing the substance. It's fire without heat. Hills exist, right? But all we want is flat ground. All we want is simplicity. We don't want to be dealing with, you know, the situations that make life harder. We want to sleepwalk to our goals, but that's not the way it goes. Hills will be there around every corner, around every turn. They're the building blocks for success, and I'll tell you why. It's not the hill in your way that impacts your results. It's how you deal with it. It's how you climb to the top of it. And the climb hurts, man. Running uphill is not fun. Gravity shoves you down, your body burns, your mind starts looking for excuses. But if you can push through all that, if you can shove all that aside, if you can reach the top of the hill, you understand what it takes. You've enlightened yourself. Because life is a series of hills. Not there to stop you, but to test you, to bring out the best in you. Because learning to get the most out of yourself is what produces excellence. It's a habit. It's a mindset. Don't avoid the hills you come across. Don't run from them. Take them head on because they define you. Thank you. One of the most impactful things that's ever been said to me came from one of my old teammates, rowing team in college. He's graduating, sent this letter, kind of reflecting back on his collegiate experience and what he'd learned. And one of the things he said was that in life, no one will ever care about your desire to succeed. No one cares about how much time and work you put into becoming great. It's all irrelevant. At the end of the day, what people see is a winner or a loser, right? I mean, you either won or you simply did not. And everything leading up to that, the heart, the work ethic, the dedication, it all remains solely with you. It's a byproduct of the contract that you signed with yourself. To go through hell, to fight in the trenches, even when you're seeing no immediate validation. Which will happen, right? If success came with the snap of a finger, everyone would be running 4-minute miles and driving Ferraris. But that's not the way the world works. But when you make the decision to be different, to give up temporary comfort for something greater, you've committed to the ride of your life. And when the time comes, and you cross the finish line first, or you realize success in whatever capacity, you can smile at the world as they look at you like some miracle, completely oblivious to the price that you paid for this. But you know, and there's no greater gratification than that. It's been said that it takes 10,000 hours to perfect your craft. 10,000 hours of walking away from immediate satisfaction to enter this sentence of solitude and dedication. It's where you weed out mediocrity. It's where you carve out your place in history. And if you're waiting for someone to come along and just make that happen for you, it'll be a long wait, my friend. Because it's your flame, and if you don't keep it lit, it will die. And a flame can be a fragile thing. Weakness, doubt, uncertainty, failures, they all want to put it out. And if you're not bigger than your body, they will. Trust me, you'll fail. Time and time again. It may not be until your 100th attempt that you even begin to see success. But if you don't have the foresight and that persistence to see past the bumps in the road, you will never know. That relentlessness, it's how you separate yourself from the people that feel sorry for themselves and watch the world from their bedroom windows. But that's not what you signed up for. Nothing good falls into your hands. It's why every day is so important. Think of every hour as a piece of paper, right? By itself, very little weight, very little significance. But committing to the grind every day causes each piece to stack up. And before you know it, you've transformed yourself and your ability. And that's what people don't see, that stack being built piece by piece. What they see is the finish line as it's crossed one by one. They see 30 seconds. They didn't see 10,000 hours. But you did. It's why you hold your head high. It's why you can smile to yourself when people talk about you, quote unquote, being born with talent. It's why you're looking at them from the podium. There are a million ties between running and success in life. And I draw from them often because they present this unique opportunity to see the world differently, to truly gain an advantage. And that's what success is ultimately about, right? Capitalizing on opportunities that are available to you. When you wake up to run in the morning, your head's clear, you're not in the midst of the day's complexities, there's no phones or electronics. It's you and the ground under your feet. Life in sort of the simplest form. I'm going to discuss 5 ways that this sacred time can be a platform for your success. Number 1 is momentum. If you were to roll a ball down a hill, it's going to pick up speed as it makes its way towards the bottom. That's the very nature of momentum. And running in the morning is a great way to figuratively get your ball rolling. As humans, we feed off of accomplishments. So completing a run, especially while the rest of the neighborhood is still waking up, it mentally puts you one step ahead of the pack. It pushes you from one small accomplishment to another. It ultimately springboards you to a more productive and worthwhile day. Number two is reflection. All things, whether good, bad, ugly, beautiful, they're all a matter of perspective. So while you may be upset that your iPhone's broken or you have to deal with some undesirable stuff at work, the reality is that someone somewhere would give anything for a glass of clean drinking water. You know, someone's sleeping under a park bench. And my point is that it's very easy to forget how much we have and how lucky we are. And it's impossible to ever be successful if you're not aware and grateful for what you have. You'll always have this emptiness as you go about your day. So while you're running, you know, take a minute and just think about everything that's good in your life. This mentality is going to help you better cope with the bad things that come up and relish in the good. You'll feel grounded. Three is foresight. Imagine a professional sports team or athlete walking onto the field or court without any game plan. It almost seems unfathomable. Well, why should that be any different for you going about your day? You know, obtaining success doesn't become tangible until you've defined your objectives. There's this saying that you can't hit a target that isn't there. Well, a run is a great time to create that target. Take a minute, think about three goals for your day. That's it, three. You're relaxed, you're calm. It's the perfect environment to think about the things that would make your day a success. You do this and your day will be much more productive and efficient. Number four is competition. When you look at the most influential people who are living or have lived, whether they're politicians, entertainers, or whatever, they all seem to have something in common. They're constantly pushing themselves to be better. And while I certainly don't consider a morning run to be a race, there are elements associated with it that remind us of what success truly requires. When someone runs by you on the street, it should be perceived as a wake-up call. And it's not because you're trying to break some record in your city at 6 a.m., but because it's a reminder that no matter how hard you work, someone is always working harder. There's always a higher level to reach and conquer. And to take this concept with you as you go about your day, it can be the difference between mediocrity and excellence. You can always run a little bit harder. Just remember that. The last one is self-image. It's pretty much common knowledge that exercising transforms your physical appearance. But what's even more important is how you feel about yourself when you're disciplined and engaged in a consistent, healthy lifestyle. You begin to see yourself as a go-getter. Human beings will always follow through on who they believe they are. The best example I've heard is if you take someone who quits smoking, but they inherently believe they're a smoker, they're probably not going to be able to break the habit. Now, in the context of our example, if you believe you're someone who gets up early, stays fit, works hard, pushes yourself, then that mentality will expand far beyond your morning run. It filters into all aspects of your life because you're working hard to stay consistent with the person you think you are. You retain a winning mentality. If you can execute on these five things, I guarantee you will see improvements in your life. There's so much more right in front of you within your reach. You just need to recognize it and teach yourself to take it.
So you look outside, right?
And the first thing you see through the window is that the running conditions are terrible. They're far from ideal. Your first inclination is to go back to bed, wait until it warms up, maybe hang tight until the rain or snow stops, which the majority of us would find completely reasonable, by the way. But let me explain the scenario from a different angle, because this is the exact situation when it's most important to get out of bed, to put your running shoes on, and to head out the front door. There is an undervalued benefit that comes from putting yourself in an uncomfortable situation, from forcing yourself to be just a little bit irrational. When you look at those who have been successful, what separates them is that they do things and they make sacrifices that others would not. They're the people that study until 4 a.m. or wake up when it's dark outside to practice free throws. Whatever the specific skill set may be, the pattern is always the same. They were willing to pay a price that most wouldn't. They wanted it just a little bit more. So what could this possibly have to do with running in the rain? It has everything to do with it. Why is it that when you run outside on a cold, rainy day, no one's out there? It's not because you're doing anything that, in itself, is great or heroic. You're running alone because it sucks. It sucks to run in the rain, right? To have cold wind blowing in your face. That's not relaxing or enjoyable. It's uncomfortable. But you're out there when everyone else is warm inside, and there's value to that. Training yourself to follow through with your ambitions regardless of hurdles, because life will not always be comfortable. What are you gonna do when things get bad? You lose a client at work, your girlfriend leaves you. You gonna stay in bed? Because there will always be a reason to wait for later, to hope for smoother waters ahead. The best, though, they achieve in spite of undesirable conditions. Then, suddenly, meeting your goals has become a habit, not something left up for chance. You don't even look at the weather, right? The forecast becomes very little significance to you. So it's cold, great, you'll wear 2 sweatshirts, but you'll figure out how to get it done. And I'll tell you, when you take those shoes off and head to work or practice or wherever your day takes you, that mentality does not leave. You look at things differently. You know, you'll realize that 99% of the reasons we give for not doing things, they're excuses. They're meaningless. If you want something, do it. And guys, that's not a cliche. That's the key to success. Find a way to get it done. And the best part, when it's finally 72 and sunny, and the world is outside ready to run, you'll have lapped that place so many times that you're not even on the same level. You have been to hell and back, and your performance will make that apparent. That's how you become the best. So is it just a run in the rain? You tell me. The will to do anything comes from within yourself. You define your goals, you map out the journey. In my mind, comparing yourself to your competitors or anyone else should never contribute to how you define yourself. What it should be used as is a tool to drive improvement, to push yourself to make the most of every little opportunity that comes your way. I heard a quote from Mark Cuban, and he said to work like someone is working 24 hours a day to take it all away from you. And I was giving this some thought. Obviously, it's a powerful message. And I started to apply it to my own situation. And the first thing that came to mind was running. It's something I do every day. A lot of the most important decisions I've made and ideas I've come up with have occurred while running. So I started to think about when I'm at my best, right? When I'm working out and truly pushing myself. Obviously, I set goals, right? I look to stretch my limits, my boundaries, and I can do that on my own. I really don't need anyone or anything. But when I truly excel is when I feel those footsteps behind me. When I know that if I don't speed up, someone will run by and leave me behind as they go on for a faster time. And this thought drives me insane. Look, I know it's just a run around the Charles River, right? I'm downtown Boston, I'm not at the Olympics. I get why it would seem a little crazy. But to me, it's the same thing as a race, starting a business, excelling at work. It's instilling the mentality that I will do whatever it takes to stay ahead, regardless of how it's perceived. Just like I do everything in my power to be that same way in all aspects of life, there are always footsteps behind me. That's how I push to stay at the top of my game. If you're not obsessed with getting better, at doing more than everyone else, you will be left behind. The sound of footsteps is a reminder that you haven't even scratched the surface of what you can do. That you can completely transform how you think of winning. And that's how you will get what you want. Listen, every morning when you wake up, you need to know that there are footsteps behind you, that a million people want what you want. They're waking up every day intent on doing what you do and are willing to put in the work. The best do that and then some. Right, they step up, they're willing to go further, be crazy. Put everything out there for their goals. It doesn't matter how ridiculous it looks. Success is doing what it takes. And I know that's vague. I know there isn't, you know, an answer written out in 10 steps. But you will find your way. You will stumble, you'll fall. But if you truly have that tenacity to outrun, to outwork everyone else, the only thing left to do is win. Surprise yourself. Surprise everyone around you. They will be there, I promise, only a step behind. There's an old business fable about commitment. First time I heard it was years ago. I was watching a video of Dartmouth's rowing coach. He was telling a story to inspire his team. And basically in this story, there's a father, there's a son. They're sitting down at breakfast. And the son says, "Dad, I'm learning about commitment versus contribution in school, right? I'm trying to grasp it, but I can't quite understand the difference." Father thinks about it for a minute and says, "Look down at your plate. What do you see?" Boy says, "Ham and eggs." Father says, "Well, that chicken made a contribution to your breakfast. That pig made a commitment." He then goes on to tell his team to row like pigs. And that simple metaphor created a foundation for everything that's come through my life since then. Right? In anything we do, there's the option to go all in or to walk the line, to hedge your bets. And people so often leave or quit when something becomes difficult because there's another door they've left open, right? There's an easier way, an escape route. But let me ask you this. Do you think if it was a life or death situation, right? Say you needed water to survive, would you give up after looking for 3 hours and coming up empty-handed? Of course not. You'd keep looking because life depended on it, right? There's no other options available. There's this old saying that if you want to take the island, burn the ships, commit. And it's not until you do this that things truly begin to change, that progress is made at the highest level. You simply cannot tiptoe to success. You can't sneak up behind it. You have to own it, right? Go after what you want like the world is on fire, like your universe revolves around making this happen. I have never, in my 28 years of existence, seen a lion walk up to a gazelle and hope that it falls over, right? It attacks it with everything that it has, speed, strength, tenacity. That's what brings home the prize. If you and your goals aren't one, if they are not the same, that's a pretty good indicator that you are fighting the wrong fight. You should live and breathe your dreams. Inhale and exhale them. They should live at the forefront of your mind, where every thought that comes through your head should be in the context of that dream. That basic question, how bad do you want it? Well, if you're not willing to fully commit to dive into something, then that gives you a pretty good answer right out of the gate. You can talk about hours spent, routines, habits, but if you aren't passionate about what you want, if you don't immerse yourself in it, none of that really matters. Live how you need to live. Do what you need to do. Be who you need to be to make your dreams real. Fully commit to excellence. Because until you do that, you will be left with only a vision and a false sense of reality. Winners don't have time for that. Okay, set your mind to your target and crush it. That is the only option. Recently, I had writer's block. Couldn't think, so I completely removed myself from my work. I put on my running shoes and I ran. Down the steps, to the front door, and down the street. It was a Tuesday afternoon when traditionally we're taught to either be at work or in school. That's just where we are. And I laugh because a year and a half after deciding to leave, to pursue my own thing, start my own business ventures, the simple idea of being outside on a weekday raises a tiny red flag in the back of my mind, as if to suggest I shouldn't be doing this. And that's what 26 years of maintaining a certain mentality will do. Changing the way you see things doesn't happen overnight, it takes time. So I'm running. I'm making my way downtown with the sole thought of needing content for this next video, right? My mission was to think, to run and to think. And I ran a few blocks, right? And I'd see people walking to school, going to and from work, taking the train, carrying shopping bags for Christmas. And all these things really make you question the big picture, right? How can so many different priorities be right? Are the things we place most value on truly most important? And I thought about it, and I thought about it, and I thought about it, and didn't come up with an answer, so I kept running. And at this point, I'm well on my way. Past the ballpark where my grandfather spent his whole life cheering for a team that consistently ripped his heart out. And I thought about how they finally won in 2004, days before he died. And how one person can have such a tremendous impact on your life. and onward I ran. I passed the library where I glanced over and my mind went right to the issues, the struggles, the challenges we face in the world today, and how so many of the answers sit right there on the other side of that wall, on bookshelves, but how we're moving away from that. Right? How can anyone truly grasp the depths of history with an attention span of 30 seconds or less? You know, I started thinking about what's going to happen, how this is going to affect mankind, and I bounced this around for a few minutes and then move forward, step by step, acknowledging that, you know, I'm spending time asking questions but haven't come up with any answers. Right? I have no content for this video, not yet, so I ran. And I ran through the common where the trees have no more leaves. It's winter, everything looks dead. And this brought me back to the summer when everything was green, when the sun was out. And I had to ask myself, did I take the time to truly appreciate that? Because now it's gone. And I made a promise that this summer, I'd never walk through the Boston Common without being grateful for it. It's a little thing, but it's a reminder that nothing lasts forever. And I figured I'd come this far, I might as well go to the harbor, right? So I continued on to the very edge of the city and I stopped. I turned around and stared directly at what I've been looking for this whole time. A skyline with hundreds of thousands of people and things and places. It was the culmination of all those little questions I'd been asking. And I realized that to know everything, to pretend to know everything, is all wrong. That's not what it's about. It's about progress. It's about learning a little bit at each stop along the way. Never allowing yourself to be stuck or closed-minded in a way that inhibits change or growth. Life is a marathon. It's not a sprint. You don't win your first mile. You win by trusting in your ability to figure things out as they come, to evolve, to adapt. And above all, to believe that even though something may not be happening right now, in the present, it can and it will be done. The finish line isn't there 2-3 miles in. You can't see it. And if you're moving solely off of what can be seen or guaranteed, you won't get there. But if you trust that each step you take is one piece of something far greater that you deserve, that was meant for you, the sky's the limit.